Hey, it's Prerak and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we're working on the intake of my 1.2 TSI Polo GT. Let's get right to it. The stock intake plumbing is very restrictive and does not let the car breathe very well. The easiest and most economic way to free up some of this restriction is replacing the air channel up front. This right here is the stock air channel, which is shut from the front and allows the inlet of air just from the side. Hot air from the inside of the engine bay gets picked up by the intake because of it. The Eurospec air channel right here helps a little with that. It makes the intake pick up fresh atmospheric air right from the grill. It is shut from the sides as well, so the amount of hot air that is picked up from the inside of the engine bay is greatly reduced. And replacing it is a child's play. Use the screwdriver provided in the toolkit with Torx bits on it. There are just two screws on either side of the air channel holding it in place. Undo those first. Then there are just four tabs holding the deflector or mouth of your intake pipe in place. Push those four tabs in, free up the deflector and remove your stock air channel. Trust me, it's easier when done with two hands. Now to put in the Eurospec air channel, it's the exact opposite of removal. Put the channel in place, screw it in and push the deflector back on with its four tabs clicked into place. Go on a short drive to have the feel for it. I highly recommend putting in premium fuel after this mod if you had not already been putting it in the car. I shifted to XP95 and that was a great decision. Euro channel makes the low end a little sharper and with the fuel upgrade and extra air coming in, the mid-range had a lot more to offer as well. This is the most economic performance mod in my opinion, which is totally harmless. The only drawback might be that if you reside in a dusty environment, then your air filter might get clogged sooner, so keep a check on that depending on your area. I did not face any issues in the time that I had been running it. Let's understand as well what this extra air does though. With more and slightly colder air coming into the engine, the brain of the car demands a little extra fuel. To maintain the proper air-fuel ratio, this extra fuel, which is premium now if you have upgraded to it, makes for a slightly bigger explosion in the cylinder and hence gives you more power. The sharper low-end response is just because of the air is a lot free now. So if you are on a budget and want slightly better performance, you can go with the Eurospec air channel and shift to premium fuel. The Eurospec air channel can be added to most of our common Volkswagen engines, including the 1.5 TDI, 1.6 TDI, 1 litre TSI, 1.2 TSI, even the older MPI engines can take this, but I am not sure if they will benefit from it. Now I had been running the Eurospec air channel for a while. I wanted sharper low end response yet again, so this is what I ordered from Budmo. It is a Fabia VRS intake pipe and deflector. This is a quick comparison of the Fabia VRS pipe and the stock pipe from my Polo GT. You can clearly see the difference with the width of the pipe, and here you can see the clear difference with their opening as well. The stock deflector is narrow and restrictive, while the other deflector is really wide open and maintains that width all the way to the airbox. Now there is some rubber treatment done that you can see, which is not stock. The deflector and the pipe actually don't want to stay together, unfortunately. So I cut up a tube into one long rubber band and another tube to create an O-ring so that it can have a seal. And so it stays together, that's all. Now to replace with the Fabia VRS pipe, we need to pull the stock pipe out. And it is easier when the engine is cold. Right now it is a little hot, but I can still work with it. These four tabs that I mentioned earlier, you just pull those out and the front section of it is free, like so. And if you can reach back here, of the stock pipe, what I'm doing is, imagine this is the stock pipe right now. What I'm doing is squeezing this end, like so. Squeezing this so this tab and this tab can clear from the stock air box. So just imagine that this is the stock pipe. All I'm doing is squeezing this from the back so I can just pull it out. And I have pulled out.
Now, one thing I should tell you is that this Fabia VRS pipe is a tight fit. As you can see, I actually installed it once and you can see all the scratches here, right? It comes in contact at a lot of places, so be careful while installing it. And the only part that would not want to fit is the pipe and the deflector. They won't want to fit together. So this is what I've done. Cut up a tube, made some rubber bands out of it, created an O-ring for the deflector as well, and just fit it all together. Now it's pretty tight, doesn't want to come loose whatsoever, and it fits into the Euroduct as well, so there are no other fitment issues except for this right here. And as always, installation is the opposite of removal. I'll route it through here, through this part, alright, underneath here. You can remove this if you feel like, but right now I don't feel like removing it because I'm going to do a quick comparison of the air temps again. So I'll install it.
It went in peacefully, there was not much space to work with, so I had to make sure that there was no gaps left where the pipe was connecting to the deflector and the airbox. And here you can clearly see it is a tight fit.
Now with all the air restrictions removed, the air filter is going to get dirtier a lot quicker. So now your regular 1 year service intervals is not going to cut it. You need to clean your air filter a lot quicker now, like on shorter intervals. Say you get it cleaned at 12 months, now you clean it at 8 months or 6 months depending on your use and the area you live in. So instead of just replacing the stock air filter, I say go with a performance air filter which can be cleaned as well. So as you can see, this is the performance air filter which can be cleaned, washable, reusable air filter. So with all the restrictions removed and depending on the area you live in, just clean it every 6 months or 8 months, depends on your usage. So let's finally install the stock replacement air filter now. It's just these 7 screws, these are T20, Torx T20 holding it in, so let's undo those.
After removing the screws, I removed the turbo inlet pipe as well. I wanted to show the process a little more clearly, this is why I removed this inlet.
So for the length of the video where I'm either going to be talking about the air filter or the box itself, I've covered the turbo inlet with a rag and so nothing can get inside of it, any dirt or an insect even, because it directly hits the turbine here, so no dirt or insects or anything of any sort should go in there.
This right here is the performance air filter. The stock air filter can just be twisted off the bracket of the airbox. The high performance air filter comes with an adapter plate which needs to be attached to it. And then just twist it back into the airbox. Bolt in the screws again. Put the warning sticker on the airbox so anyone who does the service next does not throw this reusable air filter, and enjoy the improved induction sounds. Then I took it for a quick comparison test.
The lower end is equally as sharp as it was yesterday without the air filter. But it has a little more punch now. Yes, it has a little more punch. It is sharper, but now with a little more punch. Okay. There is a lot better of pull now. The pull has increased. The engine braking has decreased. The throttle is sharper, obviously. Yeah. The RPMs are shooting up a lot quicker now. That's good.
And with this setup that I had been running now, the computer showed improvements in the average intake air temperatures as well. Now, I could have stopped at this point and called it a job done. But there was one final thing I wanted to do, and for that I needed to remove the airbox from the car completely. Right here you can see the air coming into the airbox does not directly reach the air filter. There is a partition built into the stock box to make the air travel a bit further into the box and then into the air filter. There exists a product from K&N known as the K&N 57S airbox, which doesn't have this partition and neither does it have the bottom holder which holds the stock air filter in place. So I proceeded to cut this partition and sanded down the areas which were necessary. Now the fresh air was directly going to get rammed into the air filter. Then it was just a matter of installing the entire airbox back in. The box is a lot bigger than I expected it to be, and here you can clearly see the air filter unlike before. The airbox is held in by two rubber mounts which get pushed into pins and then just one screw. Everything was put back together very easily, and now with it all done, it was time to hear the induction noises once again. The induction noises are a little bit louder than before since the partition is now removed. Let's go for a round again. Now everything that I wanted to do with the intake has been done. That is, get the Euroduct, install the Fabia VRS pipe, install the deflector with it, and cut the stock airbox so we can remove the distributor flap or whatever partition. So I've done everything now, even the filter is in. So everything that I wanted to do is done. It does benefit from the extra air already. That's something it does. But with all the extra air coming in, the stock map is not going to benefit with it at all. The stock map is not going to utilize all the extra air coming in. All the restrictions that I've removed, the stock map is not going to do much with it. All that it's helping with is dropping the intake air temperatures. It's at 55 right now, and we've just been driving. So let's just drive for a while and see if they inch back up to 70 like they did with the stock piping, stock duct and everything. Let's see if it does that. We'll drive around for a while. With all the restrictions out of the way and everything done to the car that I wanted to, here are the results. The temperatures dropped by an average of 5 degrees Celsius under the same conditions. The low end throttle response has a night and day difference with it. The power from the low end transitions very well into the mid range. The pull or punch in the mid range has greatly increased as well. I can only imagine what it would feel like after a tune. I'm getting that done soon, but with an exhaust setup as well. If in the near future you are planning a stage 1 tune with a 1.2 TSI, 1.5 TDI, 1.6 TDI, do all of these mods without a doubt. The custom performance map will take benefit of this air a lot better than the stock map is capable of doing. But so far, I'm very happy with the sharper throttle response. It honestly is a big difference, and for the street, it's plenty of swiftness. Now next for this car and on this channel are a few retrofits and an exhaust setup followed by a stage 2 tune. Big shout out to Team BHP member Suhas307. It was because of their posts on this topic that I found out such a mod was possible with my 1.2 TSI engine. I will leave a link to it and every other part mentioned in the video in the description box down below. So don't forget to check it out as well. This was all from my side. I'll see you next time.